As you see behind me today, we're going fishing for programming jobs near you. And if you want to know where all the good spots are at that no one's been telling you about, then stay tuned to the end. I'll be telling you about true stories of people that were hired on my team and how they found the jobs in untraditional ways. And if you like content like this, give it a thumbs up, hit the subscribe and notification bell to get more of this in the future. Comment down below if you found a job recently in untraditional ways that aren't walking in the front door and handing your resume over. I have helped over 250 people get jobs in the programming industry, and I want to help you next with this video. My name is Jason Humphrey. I'm the creator of the CodingCareerFastlane.com, where we set out to accelerate your coding career wherever you're at in the process. I'm going to tell you today stories that will ultimately help you learn about where you should be going fishing. Now, I use this analogy of fishing because I figured it'd be a fun little way to give an analogy that we should all be able to relate to, even though we might not all be fishermen, because I myself am not a fisherman. And the reason I think we can all get behind this is there's a couple things we can know just logically thinking about it. And that is the first, that if we are to chase the crowds to where they're fishing, that more than likely we're not gonna catch quality fish or enough fish, or even better yet, they might even scare them away. So realistically, we should be looking for other spots that they're not. And that's what today's stories are all about. They're all about helping you figure out where you can look for jobs that aren't the traditional ways. 85% of the people hired on my team to this date of recording have found jobs based on untraditional ways. And these are the stories I'm gonna start telling you now. This first story is all about someone who found me through an internal networking group. Now, I happened to already be friends with them, but until I found them through the internal networking group, I didn't even think to cross my mind to send them the job description. Because we're connected through the same group, an email went out that they had received, and then they immediately had reached out to me. This is how they found the job. They needed to still pass the interview, but because I had worked with them in the working group before and knew their work ethic and the quality of person they were, it made it much easier to bring them onto the team. This second story is all about someone that I previously worked with. When they reached out to me looking for a new job, I was able to point them in the direction of some of my team's recs. Since I had previously worked with them, they had a huge leg up on all the competition. And because of that, they ended up getting interviewed right away to where they ultimately got the job. What did they do though to find me? Well, they reached out inside their internal network, and you can too. Whether it's LinkedIn, Facebook, Twitter, any of the social profiles where you're active, feel free to reach out. I even recently saw a NPM package updated that said the maintainer of the package was looking for a job. I thought that was a pretty interesting way of making yourself known to be looking for a job with your network. The third story here, which is almost like story three and four, revolves all around mentorship. And the reason why it's two-parted is because the first part was someone in my team that had already been hired had told us about one of their previous mentors and how great of a person they were, and that they really wanted to bring them in for an interview because they felt like they'd be a great team fit. They absolutely were. Now, the other side of the story is someone who I was actually friends with who's a mentor, one of their mentees was looking for a job, came with great recommendation from the mentor I knew, which ultimately helped them find their way to our job as well. And so you see how mentorship, it's important to either be mentoring or being the mentee. Whatever side of the relationship you're on, make sure you are involved with mentorship in some capacity. The fifth story all revolves around a community. And we found this next person at a community event. They weren't even necessarily applying to our team at that point. We found them out at an event, really liked them, and we were fortunate that it was a great networking event that gave us the opportunity to talk to people. What can you do when looking for a job like this? Well, you can join networking groups. You can join hacker groups. You can join developer groups. You can join Facebook groups, YouTube communities, boot camps, and allow you to grow your network to better yourself for the next job you're looking for. Now, what if you've already joined communities and you're finding no luck? Well, that's not the only thing you can do with communities. You can create your own community in your area, especially if you don't have any in your area. Whether you create your own dev group, or you create a free code camp event at maybe a local library, I've seen that happen before, or maybe you create your own open source project that people join this community to better yourselves with code. This point though is all about a community. Whether you're joining one or creating one, it can help you find your next job even when you think you might not be looking. The sixth and final story is one I hold near and dear to my heart. That's because it's a story about myself. And this story is all about exposure, because that's how I got to where I'm at today. I had built a project called MeanStack.js that you'll see above now about 4 or 5 years ago. And it was an open source project because I wanted to find an enterprise-friendly solution for the Mean Stack. Now, what is Mean? Mean is Mongo, Express, Angular, and Node. I built this and fortunately built community around this and had about 1,000 active projects, some in development, some in production, using my framework. And fortunately enough, out of those 1,000 projects using it, a couple of them grew to become a part of my network. Ultimately, when the next job came up in my career, I happened to find it because of the network I built with the MeanStack.js, and the hiring manager at that time had used my project previously, so they knew all about my work and had seen and had been exposed to me before. And ultimately, that's where I went fishing. Now, did I mean to go fishing? No, but in the end, I went fishing and found an amazing opportunity because I was where people weren't. So what does this mean for you? Go out there and build an NPM package, build a project, build a framework. Make sure your portfolio is up to date. Make sure your resume is up to date. Make sure you have your domain up to date. Make sure you have great exposure, because exposure will help you with your network down the road. If you like today's content, give it a thumbs up, hit the subscribe and notification bell if you want more content like this in the future. And remember to comment down below if you had found a job recently in untraditional ways as well, because we'd love to hear your story. If you want help finding other good fishing spots to look for a job for yourself and you want to chat, go ahead and hit the calendar link down below. I've opened up 5 free 30-minute sessions a week, and they book out quickly, so if you're interested, book it up now before they're gone. In summary, there's a lot of different things you can do, from reaching out to your network, to being a part of internal groups, to joining a community, being a mentor or being mentored, and ultimately making sure you have great exposure with your network.